I think it's important to visit the students in their environment because I also send the message that they really matter to me, that I'm not only expecting them to come to see me perform, but I want to see them in their environment, and hopefully that will inspire them to come to the theater. Mm-hmm.
Do you see, take the Hispanic community, mm-hmm. does it have a relationship to opera?
I think that there is a group of from the Hispanic community that has always embraced the arts. Now, thanks in great part to the outreach that the company is doing here and going into the communities, they're getting some taste of it. Then along came this incredible piece, Cruzar la Cara de la Luna, which then speaks to not only the Hispanic community, but to any of us who have had a journey, sacrifice, being in two different cultures, not knowing which one I belong to, so to speak, and this quest to become your best and everything you gain and everything you lose in the process. And that, because it takes place within a Hispanic storyline with characters that are both American and Mexican, it really speaks directly to the Hispanic community. And I think that then they realize, oh, this does speak to me. And my hope is that they think, well, which other operas might speak to me? How else can I identify with this? Because if this does, surely something else does. And my answer to that is yes, they all do. All of these stories are universal, whether they're about love, war, hate, desire, ambition, and anything you see in the telenovelas, you're going to certainly see on the operatic stage and set to beautiful music.
So you tell kids at schools that operas can be like telenovelas.
Oh, yes.
This is very much, this is like a soap opera in many ways, right?
Yes, but we all know that the Spanish soap operas are a bit on the melodramatic side. Uh-huh.
And some operas are too.
Yeah, exactly. So they have that in common. And depending on the age group that I'm speaking, that I'm addressing, I will bring up the telenovelas.
How important do you think it is for the future of opera?
I think that without that, we're going to be missing yet another generation of people attending the opera, because what we have to keep in mind is once technology, and of course we haven't even reached the ceiling with technology, but there was this huge surge, and we are competing in the live theater world with technology and with a generation that is growing up with the texting only, with the email only, not seeing the reaction of the recipient of that text, which is touching into empathy or lack thereof. And that concerns me. And I think that the live theater reminds us of that tremendous and profound human experience of emotion. And when the audience attends the performance, they're having that experience as well. And the performer is co-creating with the audience. So there's this incredible connection going on, which we're losing a lot of with this new age of technology. I think that once, you know, like anything, there's a pendulum when anything new comes in. So we're swinging into this age of everything is media, and it has been for a while, but very, very pronounced that way. It's filtered for us. It's glossy and nice, but there's something very real about theater that is cathartic. It's tremendous. And we need that we need that culture, we need that kind of thinking and inspiration to be the complete, the whole human being. It's not enough to excel in technology or in the math and sciences. You have to be completely well-rounded.